Now I'm going to talk to you about surveillance techniques used for Varroa mite currently in New South Wales. This is only done on sentinel hives, so there's a registration approval for this to occur. However, if Varroa mite was to come into the country, this is going to be a widespread practice, and beekeepers are going to require to know these skills in relation to monitoring their hives for those Varroa mites. This then indicates when treatments are required. There's a couple of main different types that we use for this process. One is Bavarol strips, which are like this. You get four strips in a package. You can see I'm wearing gloves when I'm handling these things. These four strips get placed into the brood box of the hive. They're left there for a set period of time. For the surveillance sentinel hives, we leave those strips in for between 24 and 48 hours. These strips cause the mites to drop off the bees, and we put a sticky cardboard mat in the bottom of the hive, and hopefully those mites fall through to that mat, get stuck on it, and then we count those mites, if there is any mites on those cardboard strips. Apistan treatment for the hives, you only put two of the strips in, so it's slightly different to the Bavarol, but they work in a similar method in that they're just impregnated strips with chemical in them, causing the mite to fall, and then you monitor those sticky mats down the bottom of the hive. So we'll show you how to put those in. In some situations, or well, most beekeepers don't have a screen bottom board, so in that situation you'd need a cardboard mat and a piece of wire. This is one that's been used before. You can see that all the trash from the hive that's dropped onto the sticky mat and stuck on there. You put the wire over that sticky mat when it goes onto the bottom board of the hive to prevent the bees getting stuck on that sticky mat. For our sentinel hives in New South Wales, we've got bottom boards like this that allow us to put those sticky mats in. They've got the screen mesh bottom boards so the bees don't get stuck on the sticky mat, which slips in underneath and gets moved in and out via that method. So we've designed a bottom board to make it easier for that job to be done. In this hive that we have here, it also has a removable bottom board and a screen down the bottom, so we can do that. I'll jump into the hive now and show you how to place those strips within the colony. We don't want to disturb the hive too much in this process. We just want to remove the supers and get down to the brood box where those strips will go. And in some situations, you can just feed those strips. I have the four strips here. You place them evenly throughout the brood chamber. So just pop them in through there. You can leave the excluder on the hive. They've got lugs that can go over the frames or into the excluder to hold them in place. So just placing them, I'll just make it a bit easier. So you can see those lugs are made to go over the frame, so you can fold them across and they rest on the frames within the colony. I'm just putting it through the excluder though, it does the same job, just holds them in place down in that brood chamber. So that's those in place. If I didn't have that screen bottom board, I'd be putting this type of situation in under the brood box on the bottom board. I've got the screen, so I've got it easy, so I can just pull that out. Place the sticky mat on there. Sticky mat's obviously got a protective piece of paper over it. You've got to peel off the sticky paper, the paper that protects the stickiness, I should say. Place that on the slide and slip it into place. So any mite that may be in there will hopefully fall down onto that sticky mat. We then go and examine that sticky mat after a couple of days and see if there is any Varroa mite within the colony. This is done around high-risk entry points into the country, what we consider high-risk entry points, such as the ports, Port Botany in Sydney, Port Kembla down in Wollongong, and Newcastle. It's done every 2 months for the port surveillance program. But as mentioned, if varroa does come into the country, this is a practice that all beekeepers will need to learn the skill of for monitoring for varroa mite within their colonies.